All right, good morning, everyone. It is 7 o'clock in the morning. We are getting some bales ready for the bale guy to chop up. It's 19 degrees. Let's get to farming.
So I just got home like 2 days ago for Thanksgiving and Christmas break. They're giving us like 45 days off.
So those two bales over there are from the last time the guy came out. Dad started getting to the silage pile, so we'll get more into that later when we're feeding calves. So the bale grinder guy just came. He's unloading his auger way over there. I'm still unwrapping the net wrap. Of the grass bales. Last time we did some alfalfa bales and grass bales, but this time we just did some grass. So now he's gonna move that truck around and then we're gonna do some of these corn stalk bales.
bales chopped up. So now I'm just checking on the cows with the drone. Right now we got one out way over there. Right there, as you can see. Otherwise, everything else looks good. Battery's about to die on it, but. After Dad gets him in, we're gonna go wean some calves. They're in the second pasture way over there. We're gonna lead them into the lot, and then we're gonna separate the cows from the calves, and then let the cows back out. The calf got in, so he's coming back now. We're gonna be feeding right now. This is our new feeder egg we just picked up. Our old one's the one right there. We've had that thing for like 15 years. I don't know. I only remember having that one. So this one's a lot newer. Penta. I don't know the brand, but it's a lot nicer, Dad says. So I'm gonna be feeding today. He's gonna be loading us up. He's over there with the skid loader.
Just make sure to zero this out. So we don't know what this is, it's just a gauge to tell us how much is in the feed wagon. Does it by the pounds? You can tell when Dad's feeding, all the dust and debris kind of go off, especially when it's windy like it is today, and it goes into the skid loader. So it's really nice with this new one, it has the enclosed calves, so it doesn't get filled with all that dust and stuff, and Dad doesn't get covered in it. We do two different loads of rations. This one is for the cows, and then the next one's gonna be for the calves. We were kind of worried about how high the bucket would be able to go over, because there's that extra about a foot of that black stuff up there. So our old skid loader wouldn't be able to do it, but this one does. I think it has a height of like 80 inches.
Dad's dropping a little bit of feed off right now, so they eat a little bit. And then we're gonna start weaning the calves so we can see how well I messed this up.
Looks like this calf has a limp.
Those were the last of the cows. We got everything else sorted out. Dad and I are gonna eat. It's like 12:30 and we haven't eaten yet. And then after that, we're gonna feed the other calves over here. And then I think we're gonna haul some hay. So this is what it looks like when it's all mixed up. Usually we put like ground corn in it, but the silage that we chopped in the fall had enough corn in it that we didn't need to. Now for the next week, they're gonna be all freaking out because we took the babies from them, and the babies are all gonna be freaking out because they don't know where their moms went, but. We're gonna get this back shed ready for these calves that we just weaned. So we're just gonna move the baler out, clean it all up, and get it ready. We're gonna put bunks in here so we can back the feeder wagon up and feed them every day. Looks like he's seen better days.
So I lied about that corn thing. So we don't give any to the cows, but we do for the calves since we're wanting to fatten them up. So Dad's over there getting the ground corn.
This is for the calves, so it's not gonna be as much as we did for the cows. They get different rations than the cows do. These calves are all fed. We're moving bunks that were right back there into this barn over here so that the calves that we just weaned can have the same feed. For the night. This is going to the calves that we just weaned. Not sure if they'll pick up on it right away, but they have to get used to it.
And then, I don't know what's next. I just play it by ear.
This is the first time we've used this one back here. So I let Dad take over and back it in because I suck at backing up. And he knows how to do that a lot better than I do.